Hi guys! Today, I'm talking about a small switching power supply board. This one converts, for example, 115 volts or 230 volts AC to plus 12 volt DC and is really tiny. Warning, connecting and operating the board poses the risk of dangerously high voltage, danger to life, used by trained personnel only. I bought this one from AliExpress. The maximum output current is 300 milliamperes. The base dimensions are only around 24 by 16 millimeters that support the footprint of a postage stamp. The output voltage ripple is said to be only 60 millivolts. That would be a good value. The maximum output power is 3.6 watts. And it's cheap too. The link is in the video description. Let's see what the quality is like and which components were used. Soldering quality is good. As you can see here, the input voltage can even range from 50 volt AC to 270 volt AC. However, I think that the maximum power can no longer be achieved at 50 volt AC. But what kind of capacitor was installed on the primary side? So it's 4.7 microfarads at 400 volts. If the capacitor can really handle 400 volts, that would be good. In the past, imported products were sometimes fitted with electrolytic capacitors with a too low dielectric strength. Let's see if this one lives up to its promise. The black component is the rectifier. The regulation IC must be hidden under the transformer. The electrolytic capacitor in the output has a rating of 100 microfarads at 16 volts. It's nice that an LED was provided as an operating indicator. But is the board itself a fully fledged switching power supply?
No!
For example, a fuse must be installed in the AC supply line. An AC line filter is also essential to suppress interference. For normal operation, the circuit board must also be installed in a housing to ensure protection against dangerous voltage. Testing the circuit board. I'm using this fuse holder in the primary supply line. I'm using an isolation transformer with the line filter as the AC source. Connecting it directly to the socket would be far too dangerous for testing with flying leads. By the way, the fuse holder contains a slow blow 200 milliampere fuse. I'm soldering short stranded wires to the connection. Okay, now we can make the connection. I wonder if the forward volt electrolytic capacitor can really handle the high voltage. I really hope that real 400 volts electrolytic capacitors have become so inexpensive that they have found their way into circuit boards like this. Okay, everything is connected. The output voltage is measured again with my multimeter. The last thing to do is connect the primary voltage. Fingers crossed that no component explodes. Yes, it's working. The 12 volt DC is present at the output. I wonder if anything is glowing here. No, only the power indicator is lit. It's green though, instead of red as described. But I don't care about the color at all. By the way, you now have the chance to subscribe to my channel. Let's start with the first load test. I have two 22 ohm load resistors here. If I connect these two in series, the calculated current should be 270 milliamperes. That's almost the maximum permissible output current of 300 milliamps. The output voltage has risen to 12.3 volt DC under load. That corresponds to a fluctuation of 2.5%. That's still okay. 3.21 watts of power is converted into heat at the resistors. Let's see how warm they are now. They are currently only slightly warm. As an indication, I will measure the AC voltage component with the multimeter. 6 millivolts. At least the low frequency component seems to be low. I wonder if anything on the board is melting under load. Have you ever had a mishap with 150 volts or 230 volts AC? Let me know in the comments. So far, no change is noticeable. But what are the load resistors doing? Wow, they are already very warm. They absolutely have to get off my worktop. I use my third hand for that. This thing is very useful when working with electronics, by the way. In the video description, I list some of the recommended parts for you. Check it out. Now, the heat can be dissipated much better through so-called air convection. The output voltage rose to 12.45 watts after the board heated up. That's plus 3.75%. Still okay, but not a record either. Speaking of precision, the load resistors have a 5% tolerance. I would better measure the actual load resistance. So 45.7 ohms instead of 44 ohms. At 12.45 watts, that means 283 milliampere flows. That corresponds to an output power of 3.52 watts. But how much input power is needed for this? Well, it's 4.4 watts. That results in an efficiency of 80% at full load, exactly as stated in the specification, and better than a small conventional single transformer. The load step test. The switching power supply board is loaded abruptly from 0% to 100% by means of the load resistors, a switching transistor, and a signal generator. The voltage curve across the load should show no overshoots or anything similar. The rising edge is very smooth and without outliers. The falling edge also shows no problems. Very nice. Do you like my video? Then please give it a thumbs up. The noise test. Is the board emitting noise to the load at the output? A measurement with an oscilloscope should tell us more. Oh my goodness, the noise is immense. The peak-to-peak level reaches 10% of the output voltage. That's way too much and can cause a lot of problems. I will just connect a coil in series. It has an inductance of 330 nanohenry. That already results in a significant reduction. The peak-to-peak value has dropped to 1% of the output voltage. Can this value be reduced even further if I connect a capacitor behind the coil in parallel with the output? Here I have a 150 nanofarads film capacitor. Let's see what happens if I connect it in parallel behind the coil. That already looks much, much better. The peak-to-peak value is now only 70 millivolts. That corresponds to a reduction in the noise voltage of 21.5 dB. In my opinion, it could stay this way. If this video is helpful for you, I would appreciate a small donation from you. You can find details in the credits. The reason for the purchase. By the way, I need the switching power supply board to repair a large switching power supply. The line filter and the output noise filter are already part of the device. The 12-volt auxiliary power supply is irretrievably broken. After installing the tiny circuit board, the plus 12-volt auxiliary power is available again and the defective power supply comes back to life. Have a great time. Until the next video, bye bye.